This is Virginia This Morning with Greg McQuaid, Cheryl Miller, Jessica Nall, and Bill Bevins. And now, Virginia This Morning on CBS 6.
Well, welcome to our live Monday edition of Virginia This Morning. I'm Jessica Nall. With Arbor Day this Friday, local students are helping to make the world a greener place by planting one seedling at a time. Dominion returns for their 10th annual Project Planet campaign. Suyapa Marquez and Meredith Gray join us with the details. It's great to see both of you.
Good to see you, Jessica.
This is such a neat campaign, and the numbers now after 10 years are so staggering.
Yes.
I visited the website this morning, and you guys just surpassed last year nearly 300,000 seedlings.
Yes.
That's
so
a big
year,
deal.
In our 10th year, is 350,000 tree seedlings that we've distributed.
Wow.
Yes. So 50,000 this year throughout the course since 2007 is 350,000. And according to the Department of Forestry, that's actually 875 new acres of forest if all the trees are planted and if they all grow to maturity.
Wow.
So that's a lot.
That is a big deal.
It is.
This project starting 10 years ago, where did the idea come from?
Well, it was partnership between Dominion and the Arbor Day Foundation, and we really wanted to teach the children the importance of trees and the environment and the ecosystem. So we do it in two different ways. We give them the educational experience in the classroom, and you could go to projectplanted.com and download lesson plans, games, puzzles. And then in April, all the children that participate get a little tube like this with a seedling that looks like that that they can plant on Arbor Day.
Yeah.
Yes.
And Meredith, it couldn't be easier. You're here as our official demo instructor.
I am. I'm very excited to show you how to plant a tree today. So to get started, I'll be demonstrating what you would do if you're planting indoors. You can plant indoors in a pot. The tree will survive for about a year indoors in a pot before you should replant outdoors. So if Suyapa, you want to take us through, and I will start demonstrating how the children would plant their seedlings.
Sounds good.
Wonderful. So if you are planting outside, we do ask you to solicit the assistance of an adult to call 811 to make sure that the ground is clear. Look up to make sure there are no power lines. We don't want you planting anything underneath a power line. But we are demonstrating how to plant in a planter. You take the seedling out of the wrapper. You make sure the hole is deep enough for the root ball, which is this part right here. Mm-hmm. And you put the dirt on top of the root ball. Make sure it's totally covered. We want to make sure that's covered. Mm-hmm. Pat it down just a little bit. We have a little bit of mulch that we'll put on top.
Cute pot is optional.
Cute pot is optional.
Okay.
But recommended. You want
to
color coordinate.
It has to be a cute pot.
Absolutely.
And then the last but not least is water. Now, our eastern redbud loves moist soil, so please water frequently.
Absolutely.
And then watch it grow.
Why the redbud?
It is native to Virginia, and it grows really well here in all of our regions, and it just does really well. It's really hardy. So what you see here is actually a seedling that was cultivated from the Arbor Day Foundation. So they actually cultivate for us, and they send this all to the participants around Arbor Day, and this is what it looks like. So the growth rate is about, when it's mature, about 20 to 30 feet up high.
And that's hard to believe from this tiny little seedling.
Yes.
The benefits of a native, you know, it's conditioned for this area, so it should thrive pretty well. But this is a great option to put it in a pot, because if you don't necessarily have the backyard to take it to, you still can work with kids to get the benefit of this lesson.
Exactly.
That is correct. So what we do is we teach the kids all about the trees and the benefits of trees. And like you said, a lot of children live in an apartment. So if you don't have a place to plant it, the option for the planter works really well. And as long as you take care of the tree and you plant it and you water it often, it would really do wonderful.
The project expanded this year. Up until this point, it was for a certain age group.
Yes.
It did. It was. So this year, the first time since 2007, Project Planted was open to all ages and grade levels of children. Previously, it was open to just third graders. In addition to that, any community or civic organization that works with children was also eligible to participate. So this year, we saw several organizations, scout troops, groups, church groups, yes. preschools. I think we even had some parents and grandparents that registered mm-hmm. children and grandchildren to participate this year.
Now, everybody who wanted to do it has already signed up, right?
Yes, they have. We usually have registration in January and February because since we give away 50,000 seedlings about each year, it takes some time for the Arbor Day Foundation to cultivate those seedlings. So having registration in January and February allows for that time. However, although seedlings aren't available, I would still encourage anyone that's interested in Project Plant It, head to projectplantit.com. Check out our lesson plans. They support STEM subjects like science and math. And as Suyapa said, we also have educational games and instructional videos. So a lot of great stuff on projectplantit.com.
Yeah, the site was dynamite. I checked it out this morning and it was broken out for parents, for students, for instructors. So yes. you make it really easy. And then if you just decide you want to do this with the kids at the end of the week, or if you're an instructor and you're just thinking about it, you can still get started.
Exactly.
Because Arbor Day is Friday.
It is Friday,
this
April
Friday.
29th.
Happy Arbor Day.
Happy Arbor Day.
Keep on planting.
That's right. Thank you so much, ladies.
Thank you,
Jessica.
Appreciate it. Appreciate them being here. It's a lot of fun. And coming up this weekend, the Herbs Galore and More event is coming up. I'm not sure why we're giving that information, but Dominion's Project Planted is on Friday, April 29th. On Saturday, April 30th, we've got a lot of stuff on the screen there. I think we got so overwhelmed that we were growing trees. We put a whole bunch of information. Come on out and enjoy the fun on Friday for Arbor Day. We thank Dominion for being back with us this morning.
Yes,
10 years running and 350,000 trees.
Yes.
That is not kidding around.
Yes, and also for the event at Maymont, Herbs Galore and More, for the first 200 participants, you will receive mm-hmm. your own redbud tree seedling to plant.
Mm-hmm. Oh, see, we were in line.
Yes. We were in line.
All right.
Yes.
We want you to go to Herbs Galore and More
yes.
this weekend.
And
so does Dominion, because
yes.
they're giving out trees. First
Please.
200, you said,
First
Siapa.
200.
All right, I love it. This weekend will be
this.
Perfect to head out there, won't it, Nikki D?
It's going to be stunning. And I love what you guys are doing, because you're getting people involved and excited. And so you can watch that tree grow for years and years to come.
Yes. And the red bud is so pretty in the spring. I mean, they're nice all year long, but they're so beautiful in the spring. That really pretty purple coming out.
Yes.
They're just
yes.
so eye-catching.
They really are. It's what makes this so beautiful around here.
Yeah.
I love it. And then, too, for those kids to remember, hey, you remember when I planted that? And go back and visit those homes.
Yes,
it's
yes.
a great idea.
Thank you
so much, ladies. And, of course, if you're going to plant something, you kind of need some rain, you know? So we are looking to see some